Now, from the desert's news leader, KESQ News Channel 3 HD at 11.
Group of activists is taking on the Church of Scientology, with both sides vowing to fight to the end.
Now, last night at 11, News Channel 3's Nathan Baca investigated whether local politicians are making decisions about protest rights based on religious propaganda. And tonight he's here with more on the story you'll only see here on News Channel 3. Nathan.
In the shadow of the conflict, we're taking you inside Scientology's Hollywood complex for an exclusive one-on-one interview with one of the church's top leaders, Tommy Davis.
How is Anonymous a clear and present danger?
Really, it does boil down to hate crimes and a religious hate group that is, you know, really intending to bring about, you know, harm and bigotry and upset as much as possible to, you know, individual members of a church and a religious organization.
Now, Supervisor Stone read this booklet. He gave it to me, Anonymous, Who They Are, What They Do. I believe you were mentioning this is from the Church of Scientology. Was this produced by the Church of Scientology?
This is a publication that was put together by a group of individuals and that work with the church and also work with other groups, human rights organizations and other religions.
But it has no byline. It has no, you know, thing, you know, written by or funded by. That's just kind of what puzzled us about this booklet, because it became Exhibit 1, in a sense, with the supervisors, the main exhibit that convinced that Jeff Stone used to convince the other supervisors that this is a hate group. You know, listen to this, and there was a very powerful presentation, but, you know, we just didn't know who it was by, because there's no byline. That's why we were kind of puzzled by it.
Okay. I just told you that the church was absolutely involved in putting that together, and it was a compilation of information that's easily locatable on the internet. If you want to know who that booklet's by, it's by the people who produce the hate, and those people are members of Anonymous.
Why is a camouflaged observation post needed in the hills above Golden Era?
Well, that's no secret. Those are digital cameras, and they're used to be able to sweep the entire property for security purposes. You know, I don't know if someone's trying to give you the idea that that's some sort of secret or there's something nefarious about
it. No, I'm just curious about it because it's a camouflaged observation post with telescoping lens. It's not something you see everywhere.
Sure. No problem. Yeah, I mean, you also wouldn't want to mar the landscape of a hillside either.
Hey!
Trespassing. You're under arrest for trespassing.
No,
you're under arrest for trespassing. Hey, guys!
You're under arrest for trespassing!
Hey. Tell me what happened with the security guard. Was he bitten?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, when was he bitten?
In that incident.
Was he bitten before or after, like, was he bitten as he was being taken into custody, or when exactly in the timeline was he bitten?
When he was making a citizen's arrest of that individual that you saw there on the ground.
Was it while he was on the ground, or do you know?
I don't know at what point, but, you know, it's a subject of, obviously, that individual who was arrested has been charged, and then what you saw there was a citizen's arrest.
But why not just call the sheriff's department? At most, it's misdemeanor trespassing. Mm-hmm. Why not just call the sheriff's department? They arrived just a minute later or so.
Sure.
Why tackle them down?
To my knowledge, they had already been called.
The woman is walking up, and the guard does a back side sweep and nearly trips the woman.
And then she kicks him.
I don't quite see that.
Anyway, you know, here's the... In all honesty, Nathan, this is something that is a matter for law enforcement.
The spikes facing inward. Mm-hmm. Why are the spikes facing inward?
It's just how they were installed.
Our second half of our one-on-one interview with one of Scientology's leaders continues tomorrow night at 11. Now, we confront Davis with the confidential works of L. Ron Hubbard and ask why there are threats of death by pneumonia for those who read it. And coming up Friday, we will actually post our entire interview with Tommy Davis, all 45 minutes uncut, on our website, KESQ.com.
Very interesting.
Yeah, interesting stuff. In your opinion, did he seem forthcoming?
He was definitely giving many answers. He gave very long answers that we'll have all posted on our website as well, coming up Friday.
But so everyone can decide for themselves.
Did you feel he was still holding a lot back?
I'll let the viewers decide that.
All right. Thank you very much, Nathan.